Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to be reviewing the Lumos Firefly Magnetic Smart LED Bike Lights. Lumos is best known for their cycling helmets, which combine sleek designs with integrated LEDs for improved visibility. With their multi-LED setups, Lumos helmets not only ensure people see you, but that you can also communicate if you're braking or turning. What we have here today is the Lumos Firefly light system, which extends the same features as the helmet lights into a magnetic individual light setup. We have the four light bundle, which also comes with a wireless cradle. In terms of packaging, you can see very simple, a nice cardboard box, a little sticker with the branding stuck right onto it, and basic specs on the back. We'll go ahead and open up the lights and go over the specs. Retail price on this starts at $49.95 for an individual light, all the way up to the $179.95 bundle we have here, as well as multiple cradle options to charge them at the same time. These have magnetic mounting setup, which is quite cool, so you just lock them into place. You also have wireless charging, which lets you easily recharge them without the need for additional cables. You have multiple color modes, and that's what's really nice about these lights. They can be used as brake lights, turn signals, or front headlights by simply switching their mode through the app. You also have seamless syncing, so these will actually sync with all the other ones near it, so you'll have the same flashing pattern. And then again, you have the full app support to really customize everything. These have a 500 milliamp lithium polymer battery integrated on the inside, and again, the wireless cradle charger that lets you just easily recharge it. In terms of what comes with it, you can see a lot of stuff. So you have multiple mounts. So we have four of them because we have four lights. We have the straps. You have the Velcro strap option as well, which lets you attach it to your body or clothing. You have these round spacers that you can swap out for the flat ones on the bases. And then you can see these are all magnetic. So you get them close and they lock into place. You also have these clips here. So these are simple plastic clips that also attach to this and give you a little bit more security rather than having these just pop in with a magnet. These will have a press to release feature. So you just push down and it goes on a little hook on the inside of the light. You also have stickers that help you identify which is which, since you can use these in different modes. The stickers will help you visually identify whether there's a front light or rear light. You can also do that through the app, user manual. And then again, to charge these use a wireless charger. So again, really nice packaging. And you have this simple wireless base with a little adhesive foot. So you can attach this any direction and it has a little cute design. And then again, this is magnetic. So get it close, and then this will just charge. So pretty sleek. This is USB Type-C, and they've actually hidden the charging cable on the inside. So pretty slick packaging, and this lets you connect this. And you can also use these lights with any Q-compatible wireless charger, so you don't have to just use this cradle. Now let's take a look at the weight of the lights. So the light by itself without the magnetic base comes in about 30 grams, and then if we add the base with the C-post bumper, that comes out to 25, and then if we do the standard one, which is a little bit thinner, that comes in at about 16. So pretty lightweight overall, and then you can mount these in various ways, whether you do a silicone strap or these lightweight rubber straps, so they're both quite light options. The Lumos Firefly lights are lightweight and easy to mount smart lights that can wirelessly communicate with the Lumos helmet, app, or the remote. What's so clever about these is the fact that the Firefly lights have multi-LED designs, so they can be used as a headlight, a turn signal, or a taillight, as they have the red, yellow, and white colors inside. You also don't need to own the Lumos helmets again, you can just use the app and an optional remote to trigger the turn signals. Each light is very compact. You can see they have a square profile with a little bit deeper design with an extruded lens, so you have good side visibility. As far as mounting these, you have tons of options. So these have a magnetic base, and you can't really put them on incorrectly. So you can see if I put it on the wrong way, this actually won't attach. If I do the correct orientation, it'll lock into place, so you want the button to line up with a little cutout. You have magnets here on the side of the lights that correspond to the magnets on the base, and that's what really holds it in place. You don't need anything besides this magnet to hold it onto the base, but they do have the clips that'll attach to the sides here, and it'll actually clip on to the lip on the lights themselves as a little bit extra security. Once you have it on the base, then you have multiple options. You can do the C-post mount with this little rubber, this curved rubber backing, and you can see it just goes into the little slot. Or you can use the standard one, which is a little bit flatter. So if you're putting it on a C-post, you'll definitely want to use this. And then if you're doing flatter sections, you can just use this. So swap them out and find the one that works for you. You also know there are these little hooks on the sides. These work with the strap. So pretty simple rubber strap design. These will wrap around anything you need and then hold it in place. So you can leave the base on your bike. And then when you want to put the lights on, so if you're commuting, pop out the lights, leave the base on there, and then pop in the light to use them again. So pretty simple design. And you have a nice two-piece construction, so you can use this in various different ways. They also have the Velcro strap option that goes through the slot down the middle. So then you can attach it to your arm, your leg, or anywhere else with a little bit more flexibility. As far as the LEDs on here, you can see there's actually two rings of 20 COB LEDs around the main section. So there's two rings. You have an inner and outer. And you can see the outer ring corresponds to the red color. And if I switch it to a constant mode, you can see the outer ring is illuminated. The inner ring will illuminate orange for turn signals. And then you have three inner LEDs. And these are actually used for a little bit more focused output. So you can see two high output ones on the outer and then one on the center. The center one is white for the front light. And then the other two are for the break-in functionality or flashing modes. So you can see if I turn this on to flash, it'll actually flash the inner one. So nice and bright and gives you more visibility. These lights are rated only up to 84 lumen in the break mode. So not super bright, but with that focused lens design, they feel a lot brighter than the lumen count would suggest. They also have this nice raised profile so you can see. You can actually see the light from higher angles and you have a nice uniform illumination. That's so nice about COB LEDs. You can also customize these using the app. So on here, on the device itself, you basically have one power button. There's no USB port or anything here as it has a wireless charger in the base. Instead, you can really only do a single press to turn it on and a single press to toggle between the three available modes. You have the constant COB LED with a flash on the inside. You can go constant on the outside, or you can go flashing on the inside. So you can actually configure these based on the app, and the app will switch it between the turn signal mode or the headlight mode. You can't actually do anything here on the device itself. So it is fairly app-centric, which is one downside. If Lumos decides to stop updating the app, you kind of will lose all the functionality. The other thing I want to show is the syncing capability. So you can actually sync all the light modes together. So if I want to switch one of them, I can do that and then I can double press and then this will sync together. Within the app, you can also set up the team sync and that'll allow you to sync with other riders on a different grid system. You can also power them all off together. So if you hold one, they all shut down. So pretty cool. You don't have to go turn them all off manually. You do turn them on manually though. So I have to go through here one at a time. Press them and wait for it to connect to the app again. And then once everything's paired, you can see they're out of sync. So I just do a quick double press and then everything is back in sync together. So a really seamless experience. Each light has three different modes. You have constant, flash, and high vis. For the front light, there's only one LED. So flash mode does a different illumination pattern for the flash. And then in high vis, it does a more frequent flash. You can see run times are highest in the flash mode. With the rear light, you actually have a COB LED ring and then two inner LEDs. So flash mode will flash the outer ring only, and then high vis is a combination of the inner lights and the outer one for improved visibility. Here you can see the four light setup on our Troxys links, and it's a really nice design. So you can see we have them spaced out on the handlebar and in the rear rack. So if you have some space, you really get a nice appearance. It makes the bike look bigger and more like a vehicle instead of just a bike. Although these lights aren't super bright, they're only 84 lumens in the brake mode. You can still see they add great visibility, especially in lower light conditions or urban settings. And you can see with the syncing, every light is synced perfectly together and in flash modes or constant modes improves your visibility. The mounting on this works pretty well, so very flexible with just the rubber straps. So on the handlebars, we just use the C-post mount, which guys are nice and round. And they work pretty well. You do want to tighten them down, or you can use the straps if you want a little bit more rigid mounting. The magnetic mount makes it really easy though. You just pull the lights off. So if you're parked somewhere, you can pull the lights off and leave the bases on them. The rear doesn't work quite as well with that C-post mount, as the diameter of the tubing is a little bit smaller, but you can still see it adds great rear illumination. Here you can see the setup with a helmet light as well on a drone follow shot. And it's a really nice setup. So again, it just makes your bike look bigger. And in any lower light conditions, it really improves your visibility. The turn signals are also a really nice touch. So when you indicate the turn signal, it actually makes the other light constant, which helps make the turn signal more prominent. So especially when you're riding around town and doing a lot of turns, it's a great way to indicate what you're doing and improve your safety. Now let's take a look at the Lumos app. With the app, you can control the modes of all the lights, as well as configure some of the settings. So the first step is obviously to add the devices. So we'll hold the power button on each of them for 3 seconds. You can see it finds all of them individually. So now they're all paired. You can say I'm done. And then you can see now we have each device on here. The battery status is on here. There's no battery status on the devices themselves. And you can see they have a pre-assigned name. The great thing about the app is you can actually configure how the modes are set up. So whether you want it as a left turn light, a front light, a rear light, or a combination, front left, rear left. Now you'll notice at first it's kind of confusing which light is which. So I can click on Firefly 3, and you can see that's my left. So we'll move that to my front left. If I want to figure out which one the next one is, that's my front right. So drag that in. So very intuitive user interface, is drag and drop. And then you can see this is the right rear. So I'll drag that in, and then there we go. So now we have that set up, even have the remote here. So you can see now that'll pair to all of these. And then when I go right, I'll pair the right signals. So very easy to do. And now I can also do some more of the advanced features. So under the sync, you can see we have multiple settings. There's team sync, and you have nice illustrations that indicate what it does. This one actually lets you sync to other people's light grids. You have automatic brake light, and you can adjust the sensitivity. And then you can also do the all power off. So when you turn off one, they all turn off together, which is a really cool feature. You don't have to individually turn them off. You do individually turn them on though. So once you have these, you can also change the patterns. So if I click on one of the lights, you can see I can customize light mode. So within this, you can actually change the three modes. So you have by default a constant, a high vis, and a flash. And you have great illustrations though for the taillights. You can see it actually show what it does, and then you can adjust the power. And then if you click on the flashing, you can actually change the mode. So the flashing sequence. So pretty cool. And unless you really customize everything, once you're done with that, you can just double press on any single one of them and they'll resync. So you can also do a computer mode. This is a new feature that's not here yet, but it is incoming. And then you have the discover mode, which will actually show some of the other products and then some of their help pages on here as well. Now let's go over the pros and cons for the Lumos Firefly. What we like about them is you have magnetic mounting, so it's really easy to put on and take off your bike. You also have a Flick app to configure the light system, so you can set up each light as a front, a rear, a turn signal only, or as a combination front and rear with turn signals. You can also sync the lights with the Lumos helmets or the optional remote to indicate when you're turning, which is a really nice feature. The main negatives with these lights is the fact they're quite expensive. They're almost $50 each. So if you want a four light set like we have here, it costs quite a bit more than traditional bike lights. It also is a very app-centric design, so you really have to have the app to select the roles or to customize it. Each of the lights also lacks a multi-level battery indicator on the light themselves. You have to look on the app to see the battery status. It would have been really nice if they just added a little indicator on the light and a quick way to check it. Taking everything into account would give the Lumos Firefly an 8.4 out of 10. It's a clever light system. It's not perfect, but a lot of features are really nice, and it's a very seamless design, so it's very easy to set up. And with the turn signals on the front and rear, you can really increase your visibility on the road. Thanks for watching this review. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You can see more content from us on our website at thesweetcyclist.com, as well as follow us on Instagram at thesweetcyclist. This is The Sweet Cyclist, reminding you to enjoy the ride.